I chose UM-Dearborn because I wanted to get the feel of diversity, and a lot of people go out of state into different colleges, but I wanted to get that diversity right here in my own city, so I chose UM to just interact with new people.
I guess I will fall under your non-traditional student. I came here from Transform Oakland Community College in 93, and I had my first child about 10 years ago, and I left school after getting married, after having a child. And I came back here, one, because they were welcoming for a 35-year-old woman with two children and an ex-husband. They worked with me so well to get me financial aid, to get me back on the school track, and just still able to help me know that I can still have a career even after my 20s.
So I had the pleasure of attending a pretty special high school. It's special because it's really focused on introducing its students to as many different fields as possible. And so this is really where I kind of developed my love and passion for engineering. So I started right after graduation from that high school is when things got really interesting for me, right? Because I got admissions into University of Michigan. And the motivation behind entering the university was that I understood that if I wanted to be able to pursue and thrive within the field of engineering, that this was the number one school in the state to do so. So it's really, I couldn't see myself attending any other school really, because it was going to set me up or position me to be successful in that field.
Like, I think someone else has said something about the Engineering Center. I actually worked for Ford Research and Engineer, and they do a really good job preparing the students. I feel like that was like real life experience, you know, getting them prepared.
My favorite class was during one of my first semesters here. It was a speech 101 class. I remember doing my first speech, I was absolutely nervous. My voice was shaking, I was sweating, my palms were sweatier than they usually are. It was crazy. I never thought I'd be the type to enjoy public speaking or even be able to do it. And throughout the course, I blossomed, I bloomed, and I just became this, I don't want to boast, but I got a lot better at it. And I enjoyed it more than anything, and I thank more than anything the college experience and coming to this college and coming to this class for being able to grow in that aspect of my life and learn that skill. And actually now I enjoy the adrenaline rush I get from public speaking, and I can't imagine a life where I didn't discover that about myself. So I'm really thankful for that from UMD, and yeah, Speech 101, take it.
My favorite professor here was Dr. Peer. I had him for psych. And he was very, like, first of all, he was, like, very knowledgeable on the topic, because I think he was, like, a psychologist, too. Like, so he knew straight up what he was doing. And he just always made the class interesting. Like, he wouldn't just give us a bunch of definitions and be like, okay, memorize this for the next exam, you know. He was, like, very interactive with us and, like, gave a bunch of, like, real-life examples and always had, like, videos or, like, something to show to, like, better explain the topic that he was discussing. And I don't know, he was very funny. Like, he always cracked jokes in class too. Like, it was always relatable to the topic, which made it even better. So you'd always remember, like, refer back to whatever he was talking about in class, and it just clicked.
Because a lot of the students are paying their own way, I think their biggest problem, let's put it this way, in some other campuses, the biggest problem is substance abuse, right? Partying, having a great old time, which is fantastic. As long as you don't keep doing it through your entire adulthood, but here it's sleep deprivation. What I'm thinking is I don't think the students phone it in as much as opposed to some other places, because they've had to, like, you know, push buggies at a Kmart or you know, make 1,000 pizzas for Domino's, you know, to make their tuition. I think that there's a more of a sense of what the real world is among the students here as opposed to some other places.